To log into Webex, go to cccs-meetings.webex.com. When you first get to Webex, you'll need to sign in using your college email and then click Next. Then it'll ask you to sign into the system login. You're going to use your login information for campus computers. So for this, I'm going to put CCC / my S number and then my password that I use to log on to campus machines. Now I've blurred out my S number, and the reason is because it's private information. So just know that you need to put your S number with a capital S. Once you've added that, please click sign in. And now it should take you into your personal room. In order to get people to visit you in your personal room, you'll need to give them this URL. You can click on it and copy it and send that to them so they can join you. Now, if they ever go to your personal room and you're not logged in, but they need to talk to you, there is an email that it will send that says somebody is waiting for you in your personal room. Now, this part is really important. When you go to start a meeting, you need to actually choose whether you do the desktop or the browser version. The browser version is a streamlined, slimmed down version of Webex, and we actually don't recommend that because it doesn't have all the features that the desktop app does. In addition, we're trying to make sure that everybody has the same kind of look to their Webex experience so that we can help each other troubleshoot, or you can help your students troubleshoot. So it's really important that you have the same interface. If you just click Start Meeting, it's going to open up in whatever you chose last time, or if you haven't chosen anything, it does do the browser version, which we don't want. So as you can see, when I hover over, there's this drop down menu. You're going to need to choose Desktop App. Now, I've already done Desktop App, so I can't really demonstrate this part for you, but when you choose Desktop App, I believe it's going to download a small program for you to install on your computer so that this will work. As you can tell though, because I've already downloaded this, now when I come in to start a meeting, if I just click Start a Meeting, it's automatically going to default to the desktop app because that's what I downloaded last time. When I'm ready to go, I'll click Start Meeting, and it should launch the Cisco Webex Start. If you get a message like this, choose Open Cisco Webex Start, and it's going to open the Webex interface. What it's going to ask you for now is it's going to ask you to make sure that your audio and your webcam are working well. So as you can tell, my webcam is working. I can choose to stop the video, and then this is what everybody will see, this little JE for my initials. And I can also choose to mute my microphone. I'm going to turn those both on, and I can click here and also choose to have Webex call me, or I can call in so it'll give me a phone number to call. Or I can choose don't connect audio, which we don't recommend, but usually what you're going to want to do is use the computer for audio. Now in this settings section, this is where you can choose what speaker you're going to be using. So I can use my microphone, which is what I'm using now, or I can use the speakers that are built onto my machine. So this is probably what you're going to choose. If you have headphones connected, it might also list the headphones here, and then you would choose that. You can also choose what microphone. I have an internal microphone and I have this Yeti stereo microphone, but because I'm using this for the tutorial video, I'm just going to leave it on use system settings. Actually, I'll change it to my internal iMac Pro microphone so that both the tutorial video and Webex aren't using the same microphone, which will cause errors. So you're just going to need to choose which speaker and which microphones you want it to connect to. I highly recommend that you hit test in order to make sure it's working. So you should be able to hear that chime and see the wavelength happening here. As you can see, as I'm talking, it's showing the audio level for the microphone, so that means it's working as well. So once you're done, you can click off, and then you can choose to start the meeting. Okay. So now that I'm in here, it's showing, again, it's going to bring up the settings, and you can see that I kind of changed, it changed my options back to different options. So for some reason, it doesn't have a save button in this new version of Webex. So I think what's happening is it's defaulting again when you get in. So I'm going to change my speaker again because I want it to come through my computer speakers. And I'm also going to choose the internal microphone just so that it doesn't interfere with my tutorial video. Okay, so you can also choose to automatically adjust the volume. So it's going to adjust it based on everything else happening in the classroom and people's audio levels. So I recommend you leave that connected. And then it'll ask you what web camera you want to use. So again, I have a built-in one and that's what you're seeing here. So I can go ahead and close that. And now I'm just waiting for people to join my class.